Dear Angelo, come here. I'm preparing the Christmas tree.
Hi, Michela.
Hi. Hi. Our friend of PCB Way sent us that nice decoration. Do you like it?
Ah, very nice.
And that small box?
This is a gift for all our friends.
Today, we are doing an unboxing video.
What? An unboxing video? This is not an unboxing video.
Okay, just a joke. In the past months, many of you asked us about solder mask. Can you do it like this? Can you do it like that?
We thought about it, and we have a couple of solutions.
Today, we are going to show you the first one, that allowed us to realize this. At the beginning, we looked for a solution that could be implemented without big effort and that could work on our machine.
Most of the existing solutions imply the solder mask removal after the ultraviolet cure procedure. The removal can be mechanical or made by a powerful laser.
The first solution has been discarded, since it needs a custom spring bit made with a great mechanical precision.
We test the second solution with Caterpillar. And we realize that the laser head is too big and require a lot of power.
At that point, we had an idea. Why remove the material if we can cure it selectively with a laser a lot less powerful? That's where we did a bit more experiments with Caterpillar, but with less power and with different solder mask paint colors.
In our experiment, the black was the paint that needed less power and was easier to cure.
Also, blue and green can be cured with a bit more of power, while yellow and red are not usable.
The speed of curing depends on the thickness of the deposit paint layer, among other things.
Now, we are going to show you just a proof of this concept.
To be a fully working solution, we miss some mechanical, electronics and firmware modification.
We will work on it. But we wanted to show you a bit of what is going on. We created this piece where a small laser head can be inserted and the whole piece can be attached easily to the hand machine.
The laser points to a 45 degrees mirror and the mirror reflects in such a way that the laser beam is aligned to the bit position.
The mirror we used is an accessory sold with the USB boroscope camera that we use on the hand machine, but there are likely other mirrors that could be used instead.
Let's see how our solution works.
First, we spread a thin layer of solder mask paint as evenly as possible.
On the machine, we removed the AR8 collar and the laser head has been applied and connected.
To drive the laser, we use the spindle PWM signal in TTL mode. The laser we used is nominally 1 watt, but we observed that the real absorbed electrical power is less than 500 milliwatts.
Nonetheless, the laser is always to be considered dangerous, so use the necessary safety devices. The reachable resolution is directly correlated to the beam focusing. If you are able to properly focus the laser, you may reach a very high resolution.
In this example demo, we reach a spot of about 0.1 mm, but it's possible to do better than this. After a couple of beers, we had another idea.
What about the seal screen? Can we do it in the same way?
And so we tried, but up to now we had problem with the adherence of the layer and with the resolution.
We hope you like this solution, also if it's not fully implemented. For this reason, we will release only the mechanical part in our beta folder.
For the second solution we had in mind, we still don't know if it works. But if it works... For sure, we will need a lot of material, a lot of work, and a lot of time for testing.
About this, if you want to contribute, you can do it from our repository. We will appreciate that.
So, thanks to PCBWay for the nice gift boards.
And we wish you a very Merry Christmas.
And a Happy New Year.
Ciao! Bye.